Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello guys, welcome to Ikeda. Today we will see problem number 3 on Thevenin's and Norton's theorem, which include dependent sources. You can see here, we are supposed to find current in 9 ohm resistor, that means this resistor. So to find current in this resistance, we can use Thevenin's and Norton's theorems, and that we will be using here. There is a dependent source which you can see. It's a voltage source 6 into Ix. So it depends on this current Ix. So we know that step number 1 is calculation of Vth, that is Thevenin's voltage. Step number 2 is calculation of Isc, that is I short circuit, which is through this branch. So first what we will do for step number 1, we will open this branch, we'll give this name as A and B, and in step number 1 we will remove this resistor and we will put it there in the end when we will be able to calculate the current through this 9 ohm resistor. So we'll redraw the circuit, because for Vth we don't require this 9 ohm resistor, we remove it. So let's redraw it. So here I have drawn the circuit again. As usual, these A and B terminals, they are open circuit, but I have put there Vth, a voltage source which is to be calculated. These are the polarities. And now what we will do, see, there is a current Ix which is going here, and because this is open circuit, between terminals A and B there is open circuit. So the total current through this circuit itself is going to be Ix. So let us find that current first, and then we will be easily able to calculate Vth. So to find this current Ix, we can apply KVL to this circuit, to this loop. So let's apply it. Now this voltage source is negative and positive, so we are moving from negative to positive terminal, so it is considered as positive. And for this resistance, our loop and current direction are same, so it is going to be negative. So this will get cancelled. So this current is what we have got, equal to 5 ampere. Now Vth is nothing but voltage across this resistor, which is of 6 ohm. So we can write Vth equal to, voltage is resistance times current. So resistance is 6 ohms and current is Ix, which is equal to 5 amperes. So we are done with our step 1, which is Vth, that is equal to 30 volts. Now step number 2 is calculation of Isc, for which we will have to short this branch. So let us do it. Now for calculation of Isc, this A and B are shorted. And when this A and B are shorted, you can see that this 6 ohm resistance becomes redundant. That means current Ix across this resistance is 0. And when this Ix becomes 0, this voltage source will also become 0. That means these two terminals can be now short-circuited. So we can now redraw this diagram with this branch as open and this branch as short-circuit. And now because this is short-circuit, this is also short-circuit. Now this Isc current is very easy to calculate. So this current is going to be voltage divided by resistance. So it is going to be 5 amperes. So we have got Isc and we have also got Vth. Vth is 30 volts. So now what we will do, we will calculate Rth and we will draw the equivalent circuit. So here comes the equivalent circuit. This is the resistance across which current is to be calculated, which is 9 ohms. This is the resistance. Find the current in 9 ohm resistance. We first open circuited it and then it was short circuited. And the whole circuit is now represented by using VTH and RTH. And now if you want current across this 9 ohm resistor, let us call that current as I, or current I across 9 ohm. Current is voltage divided by total resistance. So voltage is 30 and total resistance is 6 plus 9, which is equal to 15. So it is going to be 2 amperes. So this is our answer. So thank you very much guys for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and do subscribe to Ikeda. Thank you.